Welcome back to Sipa's Bimmer Garage. This time we are installing Gauge.S to my E30 cluster here. Me and Sorek have been prototyping this for a couple of last months and now it's ready, so this is some of those prototypes, but here I have the actual production version, so let's install this to my cluster. This is a little bit different than your normal one because this has the oil temp gauge here that is not original, but I will show you pictures how this differs from the actual original E30 cluster, so you know how to install this to the unmodified cluster. But anyways, this oil temp gauge, this is stuck, I don't know why, it doesn't move anywhere, it's broken or something. So yeah, it's good time to install this gauge.S here to replace that broken oil temp gauge and we can have the oil temp in this one also. Okay, as a first task, we of course need to remove the cluster. To do that, we first need to remove the bottom dash cover under here. Then we can reach out to this plastic panel here. There is this kind of thumb screws on this panel, if these are still there. Usually these aren't, but there should be this kind of aluminium thumb screws holding on this panel here, that you can reach down here. But after you have removed both of these thumb screws, then this panel should come off like this. And here you can see better how these thumb screws work, so yeah, there's this kind of stud and the thumb screw goes there. Then you need to remove this bezel here. There's four screws at the bottom. There's long ones in the corners. Then there's two middle length ones on the top. And lastly, there's two short ones in the middle. And then the bezel just comes off. And now we are only left with these two screws here holding the cluster. Now we should get this out like this, you can twist it. And now there's two or three connectors back here that you need to remove. So just pull the tab and pull it out. Same one on the other side. There might be third one on the middle, but these are color coded so you cannot really mix those up. And yeah, now the cluster should be free. And we can take this inside. Now when we have the cluster on the table, we need to open it up. There's a couple of screws here that we need to open. The screws are off, so this should come apart now, like this. Now it's also a good time to swap out those batteries here, because those tend to go bad. I think in this one those are, because this cluster is acting up. So let's do that first now. I have new batteries here, so we need to only open that one screw here. This has nothing to do with the Gauge.S install, but these batteries tend to go bad, and if you haven't replaced these, those are probably empty, and then these clusters can act up in many different ways, so that's why I'm doing it right now. Okay, these are supposed to be 3 volts, this is 2. This is 2 also, so yeah, quite empty. So I will replace these. Here are the new ones. This should be the same. Yeah, 3.2, so yeah, much better. That's now done. I don't really recommend doing it in this way. I would just solder this off directly from the PCB and then buy these batteries with the tabs already welded on these batteries. Because you can get these batteries without the tabs or with the tabs. The others are of course a little bit more expensive. But I would just buy the versions that already have tabs in them and just change these with the soldering iron. But I have the battery spot welder, so I could do in this way, and this seems fine, so yeah, now we can continue. We can now put this board back in, but I need to grind this corner a little bit for the Gauge.S installation, so I'll do it now before the PCB is in here, so that makes this clean up a little bit more easier. So yeah, let's grind this corner a little bit from here. Like that, that should be enough, so now we can put back on the PCB. To do the Gauge.S installation, we first need to take apart this gauge assembly You first need to carefully remove the needle. To do that, let's lift that like this and then mark the position there with some kind of, I don't know. After we have marked the position of this needle, we need to pull it out. You might need some kind of tools, but let's see if I can do this with fingers. Yeah, it came off quite easily because this has been taken apart quite many times already. But yeah, then we need to open those screws. We also need to take off this pin here. Carefully. Like that. Now the gauge face comes off. Then this thing. Then we need to remove this one. This is normally the fuel consumption gauge. In this one, this is modified to be the oil temp gauge, but this is somewhere stuck or some. I don't know what has happened for this, but this is stuck. Now it's good time to flip this to other side. We can remove this whole gauge assembly by opening these three screws here. In here it is now a little bit different from the normal cluster, so here's the oil temp gauge and I need to remove that. There's a few wires, I will first take those off. Like that, and from here too. And then we can pull this out. Then you need to remove the fuel consumption gauge. I think this is sold in the same way, so this need to be dealt with. So yeah, in this point this becomes a little bit invasive, so yeah, this cannot be put back to stock like it was before, so yeah, the Gauge.S is here to stay, but yeah, I don't mind that. So let's take this off, and normally the gauge would just come off with this, but of course this is different, so I need to get this out somewhere else. Okay, I got that out. Normally you would need to also cut off these four wires here, or this kind of flat flex, but that has been already cut away, so that's fine. Now we will put this back on here. The Gauge.S would mount here, so we need to do a little bit room for this. So I need to cut from here, I think. So let's mark around here like this. And then along the board like this. Yeah, that's fine. That's enough guide. Cut that. So yeah, now I need to take the Dremel or angle grinder. Choice is yours to cut this off. I have now done my cut and this fits here like this. And this needs to be flat here, otherwise it won't fit because when we put this here, this needs to be flat on this PCB here. So if this corner doesn't fit against the PCB, then it will hit somewhere else when you put back on this cluster. So yeah, this needs to be sitting against the PCB in this corner. This is in a little bit angle, so this is higher up like this, and that's okay. I think now we can screw this in and then do the wiring. I'll do one change at this point. I don't have any gun terminator resistor in my network in the car, so I'll use the one in this one. You can see there's this kind of tip switch in this new version of the Gauge.S. This does many different things, but the one I'm interested in is the terminator resistor, so it should be the number one, based on the GitHub. And if I measure here, it should be 120 ohms between the gun pins, so that's fine. Now this should be fine for my use. Of course I need to put some configuration on the SD card, but we can do that later. I can put this back on. Rest of these dip switches are mainly for the analog and digital inputs and the outputs that are available here, but I don't use those in this case, so I will leave those as is. That's in there like that. Well, maybe before the wiring we adjust this gauge face. So this is basically the speedometer gauge here. and the bottom line goes like this here. And you can see here that this is covering the Gauge.S around here. You can adjust where the Gauge.S screen starts, so you don't need to necessarily modify this. I want to have all the available screen here, so I will cut this here. You need to do same for the gauge face. This one here, but this is not stock one, this is modified one, so I need to do a little bit more cutting on this, but yeah, it should be fine. I did now modify this, so last thing left to do is to modify this clear plastic piece here. This has been now modified, so we can mount this back here, like that. Now it's also good time to put back on this pin. And maybe make it black again. Now we can put back on the needle. The needle is back in, so now only thing left to do is the wiring. So we can take this off for the last time. Gauge.S has quite many of these connectors for different use cases here. Many of these are for extra sensors and that kind of things, but I'm only interested for these two here. So in this connector here we have the ground 12 volts, then we have the K-bus and gun high and low. And then on this one we have the ground and then the EC, which is the control put button for this thing. So these two connectors are something that I'm interested in. In E30 cluster of course we only have the ground and 12 volts. Everything else needs to come from somewhere else because this cluster doesn't have anything for those. For engine swap, for example M52, M52TU, M54 and so on, you would need the K-bus from the ECU to read data from the ECU. But I have the mega skirt, so that has the gun bus, not the K-bus. So I will use this connector here, and I have removed the K-bus so that I don't confuse that. So I have the ground plus 12 volts and the gun bus here. So I will plug that in here. And naturally with other aftermarket ECUs also, those have the gun bus, so you will use the gun bus for the Gauge.S connection. Then we need the control button. So I have also taken wires out of this connector, so I have the ground and the EC button, so I will put that here. Like so, and that should be done. Now we need to put these wires where these belong. The ground and 12 volts we get from this pins here, but for the others we need to take those outside the cluster, so I will drill hole around here. Because the connectors for the Gauge.S are here, so it's basically straight to here to run the wires, so I will drill hole for the rest of the wires here. Okay, these are the plus 12 volts and ground, those go away. And here are the rest of the wires that go outside the cluster. I will put zip tie here to prevent me from pulling out the wires from the Gauge.S. Put the wires through here. That's in there like that. Now we can put back on the screws on the back. Now we can solder on these wires. The pin 14 here is the plus, and then pin 20 is the ground, this one here. You can see the numbers on the PCB, so this is 1, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I did now give this one last wipe down with carbon fiber towels and compressed air. Everything that could get stuck inside, because that will be really annoying when there's something floating inside the cluster. But Now that should be fine, and let's close this. This can be a little bit tricky, because it's really close down here. You might need to grind this one here a little bit more, if needed. But this should now close. Might need some finessing, but it should go in. Looks really nice. Now we can put back on the screws on the back. Okay, it still looks really nice. Last thing is to put some kind of connector here for these wires. I have a lot of these Deutsch connectors, so I will use these ones. These are really nice. I really highly recommend using these ones, because these are so handy to take in and out and take apart if needed and that kind of things. 4-pin Deutsch is enough for this, because we have only 4 wires, but there's a lot of different models with different pin cons that you might need with these kind of things. These gun wires, these either need to be twisted wire. In this case, this kind of short distance, this should probably be okay, especially because this is like not mission critical thing. But anyways, I did twist this just in case, so you at least know how this is supposed to be. But I will quickly whip up wiring between this and the car, and then we can throw this back on the car. Here's the wiring, really simple one. So this plugs in here, like this, there's the gun bus, and then these go to the button that I don't have yet. I need to figure out something, and this end goes to my gun hub that I have in the car, so this is really easy to plug in now. So let's put this on the car. So the gun hub is here, so we'll just plug this end. We have some that's in there now. And these control wires come from here. I need to figure out some kind of button here. I think I will use maybe some fog light button or something. Okay, everything is now back together, so we can try that if it works. Well, I still need to put some kind of button here to control the Gauge.S, but that can happen later. But let's see if it works. I did already load in my configuration that I used while prototyping this on my Proteras car, so let's see if it works. No. Looks promising. Yeah, we have reading. Flickering, it's just what the camera does, so it doesn't flicker like that in the real. So yeah, everything works. We have wall pressure and oil temps and oil pressure and that kind of thing. So yeah, that's fine for me. So yeah, I think that's enough for this video. We'll continue in the next one.